these vases. I have two of these. I'm going to put this in. This is honestly, Angelica, you don't want to see it, you want to
see it. That one wants it. That one wants it.
My two pants go like this. Like, this position is really lovely.
This is basically how we make mugs and vases, alright? We have a mold. It's actually made of what we call plastic parts. Similar to that material that you use when you fall and you broke in your hand and you got to place a cast onto it. It's made of that material, similar to that. We have a shape on the inside, as you can see. The shape is on the inside. And what we will do afterwards, place the two halves together. Everybody can see it?
Yes, it's a mug.
Afterwards, what we will do, right behind me, I would love everyone to see this here. This is what we call slip. It's like hot chocolate, but it's not going to taste like it. Have to listen closely now. What we will do with this clip, we will pour it into the mold. Alright? Are you going to fill it right to the top, or are you going to leave it for a time, like 10 minutes?
Or,
yes, let's listen first and then ask first. What will happen is, it's actually going to stick to the surface. The sand is going to remain liquidy. Once the time is up, I will simply overturn it and let it drain completely out. Reason for that, so we can have a hollow deposit of a mug. So everybody can see this here?
Yes,
sir. It is a cup. Now what we will do afterwards, like a few hours also, is that separate the mold? And you have a mug. Alright? It's still very, very moist. So what I'm going to do, the same part I just touched, you guys can touch it and see how moist it is. Don't squeeze it too hard, okay? You just feel the texture of it.
Oh, that cold.
I feel it, you see? That's it. So you can feel it. Alright? And what we will do afterwards, that same piece that you are touching, that actually comes off. It actually comes off. You want to touch it? Try good? For you?
Yeah.
What will happen, like I said, this piece will come off. From here, there was the mug. You will wipe it all nice and smooth. You place all the decorations and all the paints and stuff. Similar to like what you're saying over here in the shelves. Potter's wheel. I will give you guys a demonstration of that. Yes, what is the lecture? Let me get it for you, Benjamin. Let's have you get it for you. This is actually what we call the noodle tool. Right. So what we'll do afterwards, we'll wipe it nice and smooth. This is the mud. and there's another one for me afterwards. Yeah. Yes. They use a clay that is like no texture. They still use the same method, the same mold. One is to the top, one is to the bottom. Once she's going, she places a piece of clay into the mold. She's actually going to push it up, and it's actually going to compress it into the shape. So then on the other hand, she's actually going
to...
Anybody give me an idea what this shape is actually going to be? Here it is, it's going to be a mold. Big mold. Like, what's the CS here? This is what she's making at the moment. The pieces that she just taken off, she will recycle them all over again, back into the same clay that you guys see on this side here, and comes out something like this for her.
She pull it hard and what?
She can't pull it too hard.
The air is a bit
slow.
No, it's not. It's really cold. So there's a little steam, there's actually air and water.
You want to feel
that? Actually, yes,
See,
it's similar to the one you touched back up there just now. It's still the same cool thing. Ben, are you doing this? That's what I should do. Once she sprays the water, there's something called air. It's actually bubbling up at the moment. And then she's going to put the lever down and it's actually going to fall off there.
And then it'll be like
that. Yeah, it has a trolley on his. On my left hand side.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's what I'm going to eat.
Yeah.
You can't put the
water for. Guess what that color is?
Green.
Nope.
Purple.
Nope.
Green.
Nope.
Monk.
Nope.
Silver.
Stop for 1 second. I look this direction. Look into the shop and just make, and then look back at the ball at Ben has and make a suggestion what that color is going to be. It's going to be blue.
Alright.
It looks blue, right? But what is that?
Yeah,
it's
going to be blue. Funny. The answer? Mm-hmm. Not how you give him that color there.
The person that's moving it.
It's spinning.
It's spinning, and he's actually moving the brush. So if you place the brush in one direction, it would actually stop there.
That looks good, man.
All right, and as you can see, he has all of these
here. At here. Are they looking at that?
Yep. All right, after Ben decorate all the stuff, right, he places all the pieces into the trolley. He will toy up for day or two.
Look at that.
And we see everything down this direction. So I'm going to keep the...
Did you that a thing?
Right, that's the reason I told you guys to stay on one thing, so you can open this door so you guys can see. But what I want you guys to do, we're not in there. It's similar. It's like an oven. When we were standing up at the beginning, sometimes when this is really, when it's actually fired up, you can actually feel the heat from down from here all the way up there. But what will happen, like I said, we will stack it in a height, I mean, and there's probably to my height. We have tracks left to right. This whole unit itself moves this here. And we will push it directly over here. There's another door on the opposite side, and we will close it. And what I'm going to do, you guys have to be very, very gentle with this mud that I'm going to give, right? Let's be gentle. I'm going to give you this, and I'm going to let you pass it along. Be gentle, okay? No, I'm going to give you one. You're going to start from here, you're going to pass it along, right? Just give me 1 second.
What we would do after the acquired works, we give them something called lace. Lace is definitely a substance. It actually covers all the colors. And it gives it that nice glossy finish afterwards. As you guys. What it does, it just actually has all the colors. It's supposed to be moving up. So once it's fired, alright, just let me explain it first and then you can ask me all the questions, alright? Alright, what do you hear me? We dip it in something called glaze and it just actually has all the colors, and once it's fired, it just richens all the colors. So I'm going to you make sure that you can see it glow on this one, right? Alright, we're going to go right here. Just follow the glaze. Yeah, it's actually chill for color.
I know what these from.
I just wanted to show you this here, guys. All the designs before you fire them.
Not New York,
Shepherd, Mess of Barbados, all this other stuff.
At $2 store.
Yeah, even $2 store. So, I hope you guys just enjoy the tour. Shepherd, I'm not even too sure. It actually comes up now. And we just cut them in sizes of bricks, and we just place them into the mold afterwards. We need all those by hand. There's a rubber mold. We actually just cast similar to rubber. Alright. It's like rubber. It's just a shape, and you see how he showed you guys how we actually cast a mold on your mud? You will do the same thing as a cast a mold. So you can have the shape. Any other questions before you guys go?
So how do you use it?
Good question. They're actually electronic, so there's just a switch, and the pedal that we use is just like a car. Once you press it, it goes faster, and you leave back. Yeah, it just release.
I know. See that man there.
Glaze that has lead in it, okay? What we use today is lead-free glaze, okay? Which you can use them to cook and eat out of. They can go in your oven or your microwave, okay? Yeah? At the back of the teacher, we have the potter's wheel, okay? My hands, well, we use our hands to do everything, but some of them, we don't have to go on the wheel. We just make stuff with them, okay? When you pass, you will be passing around to see them, okay? And if you have any questions, you may ask, okay? Out of the same clay, we make everything to eat and drink from. I also make jewelry out of the same clay as well, okay? And you follow the teacher, go around. Please don't touch and be careful. You could have a look, and when you get back here, you could ask me any questions you want. Yes, sir? Yes, please.
Okay, boys, you'll have to go this way. I will come back.
I'm going to tell you about it.